So when working in Illustrator, one of the issues we have is obviously everything that we create is going to be vector, and a lot of the shapes that we create are very geometric and simple, but we like to challenge ourselves and make things look more three-dimensional and look more realistic. And when you're dealing with just a bunch of flat shapes, that can become a bit of a complicated process. So what we're going to show you is a way to use simple shapes in an easy way and make them look more three-dimensional. So for example, this would be a planet in our Rocketeer series. And long story short, it's a circle, but it has a lot of going on. It has a lot going on that makes it look more three-dimensional. And that's just based off of using the same circle over and over again, and then simple line work in between. So just to show you how something like that is made, you know, you obviously want to start with a simple circle. And let's go ahead and like use our color palette. So once you create a simple shape like a circle and you want to create a shadow, one easy way to make the exact same shape and place it on top of itself is to do Command C as in copy and then Command F as in place on top. So what that's doing is actually creating the exact same shape, placing it exactly on top of the other one, and now we have options to play with. So what I want to try to do is create a shadow on the outside here, and I'm actually just going to hold down one of the anchor points while also holding option, and that just makes it so that I'm just dealing with this axis right here. So I'm creating an ellipse, and I'm going to copy and paste the exact same shape behind it. So that would just be copy, paste. And what I'm going to do for this particular situation is do minus front. And what that's doing is creating those two sides that we just created. So basically the middle part was the part that got minused out. I'm going to go ahead and delete this side, and all of a sudden we have a shadow. So for example, there's a quick way of making a planet. And you don't have to really stop there. You can keep going and making more shadow involved. So I'm going to copy and paste. Again, that's Command C and then Command F, the same exact shape on top, and give it a little bit more depth this time. And you don't have to use minus front for this kind of stuff. You can use divide, any other Pathfinder tool based off of like what you're trying to get out of this. So right there I used divide, and I really just made the exact same cutaways, but I kept the old remnants for in case I want to use them for something else. I'm just going to delete them for now, but basically what I can do is do something like that where I have a midtone. And you can continue using stuff like this. Let's say you want to have like a stripe going down the middle of this planet. You can create variation in that stripe by grabbing everything you've created, copying and pasting that, then grabbing that new shape and pushing divide. So now we're dealing with these three new shapes, and you can basically select the inverse. And now we have more options. So what I can do is make a highlight, for example. Bit of a Death Star look, but basically what's coming out of this is a final product that might look like this in the end. With this technique, you're able to use simple shapes and repeat the process of making those simple shapes using the Pathfinder tool and basically create something much more complex, all starting from, let's say, in this case, a simple circle.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to like and subscribe to stay up to date on all of our latest videos.